and impossible are two different things. Look, if it was easy, everybody would do it. So do me a huge favor. Stop looking for the easy road, because there is not. There's no easy road. Listen to me. If it was easy, everybody would do it, but it's not impossible. Nothing is impossible. The only thing that's impossible is what you make impossible. So I need you to understand that it's not going to be an easy road. Don't keep calling me and telling me you're going to get on the dean's list. Do me a favor. Don't tell me you're going to be on the honor roll. Shut up. Go to work and show me. Show me what you got. Show me. And I'm telling you, some of y'all, you lying to yourself. You say you want to be great. You say you want to get to the next level. But listen to me very closely. You talk too much. Shut up. Get in the lab and let's go to work.
Motivation is bullshit. Motivation doesn't get anything done. Motivation gets you going. Discipline, commitment, strong habits is what gets things done. Motivation is very ungrounded, right? It's all up here. Whoa, I feel good. When it comes time to bring it into practice, you cannot rely on it. Motivation is just a feeling. Grounded action is what gets things done.
I value myself enough to give 120% or don't do it. That's the problem with some of you. You always want to blame other people. You want to hold other people to the fire, but you're not holding yourself to the fire. You just said you're giving 50%. You owe you an explanation. You owe you an explanation. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and say, why are you only giving 50%? What's wrong with you? You need to put yourself on punishment. You need to tell you, no more TV, no more snacks, no more desserts, no more, no, we working out now. No more alcohol, not right now. No, I can't handle it right now. You need to tell you that you owe you something. You already in pain, you already hurt, get a reward from it. Don't go to sleep until you succeed. Listen to me. I'm here to tell you today that you can come here, you can jump up, you can do flips, you can be excited when we give away money. But listen to me, you'll never be successful until I don't have to give you a dime to do what you do. Say all in! All in! All in! All in! By any means necessary, let's go!
But people who are running toward their dreams, life has a special kind of meaning. And here's what I will share with you. That in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain, a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. But in the process of doing that, you will discover some things about yourself that you don't know right now. What you will realize is that you have greatness within you. What you'll realize is that you're more powerful than you can ever begin to imagine. What you will realize is that you are greater than your circumstances, that you don't have to go through life being a victim.
So you got to be a huge favor. Listen to me. After today, you need to know exactly what's going to happen on Monday. You need to know exactly what you need to do on Tuesday. You need to know exactly what you're going to do on Wednesday. You need to know exactly what you're going to do on Thursday. And I'm not suggesting that you have to work 24 hours. I'm not suggesting that. But I am suggesting and strategize your play if you're going to get to the next level. You never look at yourself in the mirror and say, you let you die. Until you get to that point, you let you die. You're not brave enough. You want to put it on somebody else. The reason why I'm not successful is because of my boss. Have you ever looked at yourself in the mirror and said, I'm not getting up on time. I'm not going to work on time. I'm not putting in 120% when I'm at work. I let me down.
Post you in order for you to grow stronger. Even if you fail and fail and fail, you get knocked in your fucking face 10 times. You're not a failure until you quit. You become a machine. You don't think about whether you're going to write in your journal or not. You do it because you already made that commitment. Every single day, no matter what, it does not matter if both of your hands were cut off and you have to use your freaking mouth with a pen and write in your journal. You write in your freaking journal every single day. You don't think about it. When you have built a habit, it's ingrained in your nervous system in such a way that the brain doesn't even have to consider whether or not it